Today, I want to give you an easy technique to limit or restrict bandwidth available to devices connected to your network without accessing your router settings. That's coming up. Hey guys, my name is Masroor Beg and welcome to MaazTech. Today, I want to give you a quick and easy method to limit bandwidth partially or entirely to devices connected to your network without accessing your router settings. For that purpose, let me just take a moment to explain what we are going to achieve in this video. Bandwidth, as you all know, is the rate of data transfer available to a device connected to an internet. Which means, higher the rate, faster the internet speed on your device, and lower the rate, slower the internet speed on your device. So by reducing or limiting this rate of data transfer among other devices connected to your network, you can enjoy a higher internet speed on your device. And that's what we are going to achieve in this video today here. So before we begin, first thing you need to do is download this software called SelfishNet. I've given the download link below. You can go ahead and download from there. And while you're there, make sure you go like this video as well. Let's see if you can get 500 likes for this video. Okay, let's begin now. I've already downloaded the software before and I'm just going to go jump into it. And now you need to right click on it and then click run as administrator. Now if you're going to double click on it, it's just going to give you an error prompt saying that you can't enter. Okay, now it's going to ask you which wireless adapter you are using using the internet. I have only one, so I'm going to go ahead and say okay. And now it's going to show me this box right here. What this software is going to do is just basically going to scan my network and find all the devices which are connected to it and then show me in a list, and then I can go ahead and block them. When I say block, it doesn't mean literally mean block them that they can't connect to the internet. When I say block, it means that they can't utilize any of the data of the internet. In literal sense, they'll be connected to it but they won't be able to use internet. That's what the block means. And then we have download cap and upload cap. Under the download and upload column over here, you can set the limit up to which you want to restrict the users to use the data of your internet. For example, if you want devices to be restricted under 100 kbps, you can set that under this column and they will be restricted to 100 no matter what functions they're performing. And same thing applies to upload. If you're gonna put cap on upload as well, they'll be restricted within that quota you have assigned. Now proceeding on, in this video, we're going to do two tests. In the first test, we're going to measure the bandwidth right now of this device. And then after that, we're going to block all the devices given the list. And after which, we're going to test the bandwidth once more. And then we are going to do a comparative analysis between the bandwidth before the blocking and after the blocking and see what difference lies between them. So let's get started. As you can see from the result, download speed has doubled from 1.13 Mbps to 2.05 Mbps. This is gonna give you a huge boost in your internet speed, and effectively you will be able to use more of your internet. In the second test, we're gonna find if this block feature does really take all the bandwidth from the device. So the first thing I'm gonna do is in this test is use my smartphone to casually browse through internet, and then I'm gonna go ahead and block my smartphone and see what happens after then. As you can see from the result, the internet was working perfectly before I blocked it, and after I blocked it, it wasn't working at all. It was like I was connected to the internet, I was connected to the network, but I wasn't able to use any of the internet data. So this is the best trick to fool anyone into the perception that there's some fault in the device. With that, I have to wrap up my video, but before I do that, I have to inform you guys that I recently made a Patreon page. If you guys don't know what Patreon page is, it is basically a page where creators like me receive contributions from the audience so that we guys are able to make a better quality content for you guys with improved software and hardware. So if you guys are willing to contribute towards my channel, you can click on the box below, and if you're not able to do that, it's completely alright. So with that being said, that's it for this video, and I'll see you in my next video.